Hi, my name is DJ, and today we are going to explore the cinematic language of cinematographer Chung Chung-Hoon. Chung is known for his collaboration with his partner in crime, director Park Chan-wook. Park's story, world, and characters always seems to be absurd, almost surreal. And I think this is why Chung is perfect for visualizing his films. You can see the absurdism in his lighting, framing, and storytelling. Filmmakers like him always seems to bring something innovating on the screen. His cinematic vocabulary is definitely left field, which I find very intriguing and captivating. Examining his work taught me a lot about cinematic language in general, but mostly how Chung expresses himself with his own accents. I will elaborate more on his style by tackling the three key tools of a director photographer through the films he photographed. Spoilers ahead. First, lighting. Chung says his lighting style is inspired by the cinematic photos created by Gregory Crutzen. As you can see, Crutzen's photos feel extraterrestrial, airy, and almost surreal. Now, in Chung's work, you can see these elements back in his lighting. The mixture of beauty and brutality seems to be key to his language to get his timeless, fantastical, and awkward mood in his mise-en-scene, making the subject vulnerable. First of all, I think the use of high contrast makes his world feel extraterrestrial. He doesn't mind overexposing and/or underexposing bits of his frame. It singles out the main character out of the world, as it directs the eye to the most well-exposed bit. Depending on the drama of the scene, he mainly uses soft lighting to get this magical mood. But during the climactic scenes, he likes to use harsh lights to intensify the mood. Personally, I love this balance, where the high contrast indeed gives the world and character an alienated tone, where the quality of light elevates the mood of the scene. Chung is known for his use of extreme lenses, extreme wide lenses for wides and close-ups, and extreme long lenses for close-ups. Using both extremes is a key component of his vocabulary. Every character is vulnerable. This is basic and standard for any kind of drama, even though they don't seem like it. Chung makes sure the characters are framed small in his wide frames and very tight and shallow in the close-ups, which elevates the vulnerability of a character. His frames always seem to accompany the character's mood, always. What I love about his work is that he utilizes all the methods of camera movements, angles, and framing throughout his films. He used the methods strategically, only when the scene, action, and/or emotion of the characters calls for it. This is where I think Chung shines as a cinematographer and showcases his biggest strength by combining his lights and camera to tell a story. Now I will elaborate on how his cinematic language helps the drama of the story. I think his cinematography is based on a notion of perverseness. He likes giving us an objective view of a character. He does so by making the audience feel like they're eavesdropping. Having that in mind, let's go into some examples. There is a way that Chung likes to film important dialogues in Act 1, which helps him set up the mood, the emotion of the scene, and the characters. In the next scene of Old Boy, We start with a close-up of an action, tilting to a medium close-up of an important character. Another MCU is followed, our main protagonist, both center in frame. It's very intrusive. The white is established after, small and vulnerable. This is the first time they meet. As their relationship is going to be very important, this is a significant scene. They establish the new location through props, and then lets us focus on the performance. See how we creep out here? We just got caught eavesdropping. New information about our protagonist is being presented through dialogue, something we are not allowed to know as an outsider of this world. Now, Chung adapts this technique in many of his other films. Here in Stoker, where we start with three characters, we start with the same MCU. Another MCU of our protagonist, panning into the second character. And we creep out of this awkward situation, caused by the creepy uncle, a third character. Notice how Chung decides to frame him up? Unwanted by our main protagonist. There he is, singled out. Again, close-up, tilting up to a close-up, and another close-up. The same technique, but here, he decides to make them smaller with every new frame, pulling them slightly apart. Just like in all these scenes, I love how Chung visually plants a seed for the huge development in their relationship, absolutely paying it off in the end. Also, his playfulness with his camera and lighting makes him such an inspirational DP. Like a lot of DPs, Chung used them, of course, to enhance the story and the drama of the scene. Here in Thirst, this amazing camera movement captures the emotional content of the character, elevating the action. And here, in this infamous one-shot fighting scene in Old Boy, conveying the absurdness and the chaos through an unconventional view, really painting the situation of our main character. Chung is also known for his transitions, especially through cross dissolves. Here in New World, where he breaks the fourth wall, where he catches us eavesdropping again, showing his situation through a high contrast and distorted lens as we cross this off to another scene with the same mood. And here in Stoker, Chung and Park plan many match cuts and cross this off to really show the timelessness of this story as they cut from present to past numerous times. DPs are visual storytellers, and in that retrospect, Chung is an exemplary director of photography. He knows how drama works, and he is not afraid to present it in unconventional ways. Chung is someone I look up to, a purist in storytelling through his cinematography. Personally, I love Chung's style and approach, and is therefore one of my favorite filmmakers.